All right, what's going on, guys? Kind of got an impromptu video today. I wasn't really expecting, and you'll see why here in a second. But I actually got a message from a guy named Brent Backus. I think that's how you pronounce his name. And he had watched The Hunt where I'd almost drowned there while I was duck hunting. If you haven't seen that, I'll post a link in the description below, and I'll play some video of that over what I'm talking about right now. But anyway, Brent watched the video and got an email a couple days later, and he's like, "Hey man, I want to give you a boat." And I was like, "What in the world? Is this guy being for real?" And sure enough, he was. And luckily, thank you to Hayden Krimmer, the guy does the apparel stuff for THP. He lived pretty close to where Brent lives in Wisconsin, and he brought the boat, and I can't be more thankful for Brent. I'm so excited to have my own duck boat, and without further ado, I'm gonna show you what it is. All right, so like Brent said in the email, it's a 14-foot Crestliner. I don't know what exactly he said. I think it's from the late 80s, but kind of has a little bit of a flat bottom in the back, and then it's got a V'd out front here in the very front. He was nice enough to give me the trailer too. The trailer looks like it's in excellent shape. Everything's still intact down there with the rollers and everything. And then he gave me a spare tire up here and got two extra spare tires right there. So just super nice of him. Also, the boat came with this 9.9 Johnson. Brent said that it technically is around 15 horsepower because it's got a carburetor upgrade. So I don't know a whole lot about boat engines, but that's sweet. I haven't tried it out. I'm going to go out on the lake either tonight or tomorrow and try it out, and I'll record a little bit of a video of that. But yeah, it's awesome. Came with a motor. I wasn't expecting a motor, and that was great. Nice running lights right here, and up there I'm sure you can see it's got working running lights, so that's a big deal. Trailer lights work on both sides. That's super sweet. I'm glad Brent sent two oars with me, because you never know what you might get into. I've always wanted a duck boat. Actually, when I was 12 or 13, I had a 16-foot John boat with a 15-horse Mercury on it. It was a perfect duck hunting boat. And for some reason, I wasn't super into duck hunting, and I obviously didn't have a truck to pull it around. So I sold it, and I've wanted it back ever since I got real back into duck hunting. So this is freaking awesome. I'm so jacked that I got this. It's not a super huge boat, but it's going to be something that I can take out to a lot of public land spots. These smaller boats are perfect for a lot of the ponds that we're on. There's some bigger lakes that we've shied away from because we haven't had a boat to get our stuff into. And then just on those solo hunts, like I was on that lake, as long as the wind's not blowing super hard, I'll be able to take this in and retrieve all my ducks. So the boat also came with a battery and a working bilge pump. So like I said, guys, Brent set me up. It's literally the nicest thing that I've ever seen anybody do for me. I don't know exactly why he chose me, but I'm just really thankful that he did, and I can promise you guys, and I can promise him, that it's going to get a lot of use, and I'm going to duck hunt a lot out of it. I'm going to do a lot of the stuff out of it. I like to fish. I'm sure I'm going to take it up in smallmouth fish when I'm up with Jake in Wisconsin. We could turkey hunt out of it. I mean, you could do a lot of things with this thing. I can do a lot of hunting out of this boat, so I'm really excited. So like I said, the boat came completely set up. I had to get a gas tank, and I had to get a propeller. So very minimal charge. I gave Hayden some gas money for bringing it down, but just so nice. I can't thank the Backus family enough for sending it down here, and it's going to get used a lot. I really look forward to hunting out of it. I really look forward to just having it and seeing what adventures I can go on, and getting more content for you guys since I have access to go on the water. The only thing I might do to the boat is paint it, and I'm not exactly sure how to do that, so I'm not sure if I'm going to do that or not. I guess drop a comment below if you think I should paint it. I'd really like to paint it camo and be able to really pull in close to where I'm hunting, and maybe even build a blind for the boat out of it. But if that's something you think you'd like to see a video on or see me learn how to do, post something in the comments below. And if you have any tips for painting a metal boat like this, let me know. I'm probably going to call or text Brent and ask him what he would do. So now I've given you a tour of the boat. I think I'm going to take it out to the lake probably tomorrow because it's getting a little late in the day. And I'm just going to test it out and see how it does. I'm really excited. This is freaking awesome. I can't thank those guys enough for sending it to me. And it's going to get used. So I'm gonna head out to the lake here tomorrow, test it out, and then we'll get to hunting out of it. All right, it's the next afternoon. I had to cut wood all morning, so just now getting around to putting the boat in. But my dad and I are headed to go put this boat in and try it. I'm sure it's gonna work. Brent said that there wasn't anything wrong with it. He ran the motor in his test tank and everything worked. So I think everything's gonna be just fine. I went and picked up a prop yesterday. Luckily the local shop had it in stock, and then I got a gas tank and a fuel line. So I got everything I need. The boat's pulling fine, all the lights worked, and all I'm gonna get is a life jacket, and my dad's gonna help me launch it, and we're hopefully gonna go on a little bit of a boat ride. So doubt we're gonna ride for very long because it's pretty cold, but I do wanna try it out before I take it on any of the duck marshes or anything. So I'm excited. We might have a working boat here in about 30 minutes. Alright guys, success. The boat worked. Nothing we had to do to it at all, really. It took us a little bit to figure out how to start it, but just because it's a little bit of an older engine. We had a 15 horsepower Mercury that was a little newer that had a little bit different controls, but everything works. My dad and I both got in it, and we were able to pedal around and move pretty fast, so I'm excited. This is going to be perfect for everything I'm going to need it to be. So thanks again, Brent, and yeah, thanks guys for watching. Thanks for sending the boat, Brent. This has been more than I could ever ask for, and it's gonna open up a lot of opportunities for me. So with that being said, I'm gonna load the boat up, and I'm on to my next adventure. All right guys, we're back at the house. Sorry for all the talking. I did just want to say, give a little bit of an update about what's going on. It looks like I'm still gonna be able to post two videos a week, so those will be Monday and Thursday nights at 6:30 or 7. And then extra videos might come on Sunday. There's just random stuff we do all the time that may not make a full video, but we could put a conglomeration of whatever videos together. So there may be more videos on Sunday night. Monday night, Anna's deer kill from rifle season is going on. It's pretty awesome. It was perfect. It was her first buck she's ever shot. It was awesome. There's great footage, and it was the first buck she'd ever killed. So I was really excited. She was really excited. I did also want to just say we've got a lot of good videos coming. We've got three deer videos from Missouri rifle season, and then three geese videos that we shot limits last week. We've got several good duck hunts lined up for the coming week, so we should have good videos for a while here. So I'm really excited. I didn't know exactly how that was going to go. Didn't know if we'd be able to keep up, but we're keeping up. So in addition, me, Bryce, and Tyler all went in on two ice eaters and a generator, so we're going to have some awesome late season hunts over water. We're going to try to bow hunt some geese in city limits where we can't usually hunt with the ice eater, so I hope that works out. That should be great. I did also want to just say, if there's anything that you guys want to see, we like to hunt everything. We hunt coyotes, we hunt coons, we hunt, I mean, anything. We run the gamut when it comes to hunting, so we're open to whatever you guys want to do. If you guys want to see a certain video, put it in the comments. We love to go out and have a challenge and try something. So we already hunt a ton of stuff, and really it's up to you guys. Whatever you want to watch, just let us know, and we're more than welcome to do that. Thanks again for supporting, guys. I can't thank you guys enough for watching the videos. Have a good day, and we'll see you tomorrow night when Anna kills a big buck.